wake up and I kind of think to myself, how did I get here? But you put your mind to something and you don't let anything stop you. It's impossible to not make progress.
When Jason was in diapers, I knew he was gonna be an unusual child. He'd be in his high chair at the dinner table, and if there was any music on, he would be beating on the table. Tap, 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 tap. We realized this kid needs some drums because he's always beating up everything. And he had a band, and then life changed. January 9th, 2012, I'll never forget.
I used to do subcontract work cleaning restaurant exhaust. We'd usually do like 2 to 3 jobs a day. Go up on the roof, spray down the duct. Just like I remember a pink flash and then like a loud boom. And then I woke up in the hospital.
When I knew that we were gonna have to amputate his arm, he cried in my arms. He said, "Mom, I'm never gonna amount to anything. I'll never play drums. I'll never be able to do anything again in my life, ever." After 3 weeks into him being home, he said, "I can't take this anymore." He said, "Get my drum kit out of the garage." And so we duct taped a drumstick to his arm. He did some little tapping around, and then he turned around and said, "You know, I think I can make something work."
Seem like it's growing back, Doc. Just a side of me ever since I've been a kid where if I'm gonna start something, it has to get done. I just won't let it go.
So my current prosthetic is what you call a body-powered prosthetic. It just uses basic mechanics, so there's no robotic controls or no electronics. I use a lot of my shoulder and elbow to kind of exaggerate to get the hits that I want. It's pretty exhausting. It also has limitations on how fast I can play.
Like, that feels like it might be a little too slow now.
At first, it was a little slow. Yeah, it's a weird one.
So I had an idea of developing a robotic drumming prosthetic, and Gil Weinberg develops musical robots, and so I knew Gil was kind of the right person to reach out to.
I understood immediately what he wanted. He wanted to sense more of his muscles and be able to control the bounce of the drumstick.
Basically, we just wanted to be able to get me back on the kit and play as humanly natural as possible.
The model is trying to learn you, but you probably will have to learn how to work with a model.
Yeah, I think most of it now is like the sensitivity. I'm not training it that hard.
Also, there's a trade-off, because if you increase sensitivity, then it's going to have a lot of false positives and false negatives.
Would you like to move stiff, loose? How fast are we going to change between the kind of hits?
I mean, I have tons of ideas, but then it's just like, how accurate is everything going to be? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Okay. I was a little worried. Can we provide him with what he wanted in terms of the latency and the control? We didn't know that it's possible.
Okay, I'm really excited to see if we have signals. Ready, Ning?
The goal is very simple, but in reality, in each of the steps, it's actually pretty complicated.
Oh, see, and that's what happened last time.
We have some crashes, and the stick starts to roll around. Maybe we should have Raghav listening also to get an insight.
So what you might have to do is you just take data while you're moving it.
Like we were doing in the lab.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Gotcha.
So that might solve this issue.
It could be also the power supply itself.
Right.
There are actually a handful of challenges with creating a prosthetic arm specifically for drumming. Latency is always a big concern. You don't want to flex your arm at a second later for it to do something.
It's just delayed by 50 milliseconds. You can notice that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of nuance with exactly how the drumstick reacts. Things as subtle as how tightly do you grip it? How does it bounce? They're really hard to calibrate if you don't have a machine learning system to gather all the data.
When I heard about Jason's story, it really blew my mind. I was like, whoa, I had no idea how far we have come in terms of AI and prosthetics.
So the way the arm operates is we use EMG, which stands for electromyography. Basically what that is it's sensors that are amplified by a battery that pick up electrical signals from my residual limb.
Using these signals, we are able to do recognition of complex patterns with machine learning and then map them to specific movements. TensorFlow Lite is doing that in real time.
And so I can flex my muscle and it will tighten the grip on the stick, and I can extend my muscle and it will loosen the grip on the stick, just like it would with a normal hand.
No, the latency is, it's like none.
Awesome, that's awesome. And in the last few months, we were able to detect almost 100% of the time this intention.
I can actually feel the feedback from the arm and it feels as close to a real hand as you can get without it actually being a real hand.
I think what Jason and the team has accomplished is truly awe-inspiring. He took what was a large setback in his life and he moved an entire field of research forward.
So loose, you can actually... Let me see what it might mean. Yeah, I mean, there are drummers with two sound hands that don't have double strokes that even. It's amazing.
For the first time, if you look at him playing, you may not even notice this technology. You just see Jason as a great and expressive musician that he is.
Of course, I think there's a need to keep pushing on this stuff because there's always someone that needs help with something like this, and AI is going to be the bridge between that.